Hi, this is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. I'm going to show you how to place yourself onto the cover of a vintage movie magazine from the 1950s. This tutorial is for versions CC and later. I provided a template so you can follow along. Its link is in my video's description or project files. It includes this texture of paper scratches and abrasions, the masthead of a typical movie magazine from that era, and a folder that includes all of the other text. You can replace any of the text by simply double-clicking the large T on the text layer to highlight the text, and then type in your own text. I'll press Ctrl or Command Z to undo the last step. If you'd like to use the same fonts that I'm using, I provided their links as well. Feel free to reposition the text for your cover. I'll collapse the folder. Before we begin, if I've inspired you to explore your creativity in Photoshop, please help support my channel for as little as $2 a month by becoming a patron through Patreon. Click the Patreon card at the upper right corner, or click the Join button below the video to become a channel member. Make sure the paper scratches layers blend mode is screen. This shows the scratches as well as the layers under it because it clips off all of the darkest tones of the scratches layer while revealing all the lightest tones. Open a high-resolution, large-sized close-up photo of a person that you'd like to use for this project. I downloaded this one from Shutterstock. Since almost all of the celebrities that adorned these types of movie magazine covers were cut out of its original backgrounds and then placed onto a flat color later, I'll show you how to do it. There are many ways to cut out subjects from their backgrounds, but for this example, I'll use the Quick Selection tool. If you're using this tool as well, I find that a radius of 10 pixels works well for most sizes. However, feel free to adjust the amount if you'd like. Drag your cursor over the inside of your subject. To remove selections that are outside your subject, press and hold Alt or Option as you drag over those areas. To check your selection, press Q on your keyboard to see it as a quick mask. By the way, if you want to change the color of a quick mask, double-click the quick mask icon, click the color box, and just change the color. I have its opacity set at 100%. To refine the selection's edges, click the Selected Mask button if you're using version CC 2015.5 or later, or you can go to Select and Select and Mask. If you're using an earlier version of Photoshop, click Refine Edge. I did in-depth tutorials on both, so if you'd like to watch them, I provided their links as well. If you prefer to use Refine Edge instead of Select and Mask, shift-click Select and Mask to open the Refine Edge filter. Check Smart Radius, which will detect hard and smooth edges. The brush should be approximately this size. To adjust its size, make sure the Caps Lock key is off and press the left or right bracket key on your keyboard. Drag your cursor over the soft edges, such as the hair. Check Decontaminate Colors. This prevents color fringing onto your subject from the background. Drag it all the way to 100%. Output it to a new layer with Layer Mask and click OK. We'll convert our cutout subject into a smart object so we can add filters to it non-destructively and even replace it with a different subject without having to redo most of the effects. To do this, click the icon at the upper right of the Layers panel and click Convert to Smart Object. Go to Filter and Camera Raw Filter. Before we start adjusting some of the settings, keep in mind, since every photo has its own characteristics, the settings and amounts I'll be using for this particular image may not work the best for your image, so feel free to adjust them as needed. In the Basic panel, I'll make the temperature 30 to give our subject a golden yellow color cast, and I'll make the exposure -0.60, which darkens our subject. I'll decrease the contrast to -50. The clarity is plus 40, and the vibrance is plus 80. This combination gives our image an over-the-top punch that printed movie magazine covers had from the 1950s. Open the Presets panel and open Grain. I'll click Medium, which gives our subject a grainy texture. Then press Enter or Return to accept all the settings and to close the Camera Raw window. Go to Filter, Blur, and Gaussian Blur. I'll blur it 0.4 pixels to soften the image. Next, we'll darken the overall highlights of our subject by clicking the Adjustment Layer icon and clicking Exposure. Adjustment layers affect all the layers below them in the Layers panel. To restrict an adjustment layer to affect only the one layer beneath it, it needs to be clipped to that layer. Since we'll be adding a background layer below our subject later, let's clip the adjustment layer now to our subject. To do this, click the Clipping Mask icon or press Alt-Control-G on Windows or Option-Command-G on a Mac. You can also go to Layer and create Clipping Mask. In the Exposure field, I'll type in minus 0.40. Next, we'll compress the shadows and highlights, which creates a similar flattening of the overall contrast of many subjects printed on inexpensive vintage magazine covers. To do this, click the adjustment layer icon again, and this time click Selective Color. Then, clip it to the subject. Open the whites, and in the black field, type in 60. Open the blacks, and in the same field, type in minus 20. We'll convert our visible subject into a smart object by shift-clicking the subject to make it and its adjustment layers active and converting them into one smart object. We're ready to place our subject into the template I provided. Open your Move tool by pressing V on your keyboard. Drag it onto the tab of the template, and without releasing your mouse or pen, drag it down and release. To resize it, open your Transform tool by pressing Ctrl or Command T. Go to a corner, and when you see a diagonal double arrow, press and hold Alt or Option plus Shift as you drag it in or out. If you're using CC 2019, just press Alt or Option as you drag it. To reposition it, go inside the bounding box and drag your subject. Then press Enter or Return. Let's drag our subject below the paper scratches layer. We'll add a background color at the bottom of the Layers panel. Make the text folder active and create a new layer below it by control-clicking or command-clicking the new layer icon. Let's name it Background. Click the foreground color and pick a color for your background. Since I already know the color I want, I'll type it into the hexadecimal field. 385981. To fill the empty layer with your foreground color, press Alt or Option plus Delete. To ensure that all of our text is visible and not hidden behind our subject, we'll drag the text folder above our subject. To change the color of your text, open the text folder and double-click the large T of the text layer that you want to change. This activates and highlights all the text in that layer. Click the color box in the Properties panel or the box at the top of your screen. For this block of text, I'll pick black. Double-click the large T of the Your Name Here layer and type out the name of the person on your cover. I'll change the color of this block of text by repeating the same steps. To change the color of the masthead, double-click the masthead layer to open its layer style window. Click Color Overlay and the box. Pick a color that complements your subject and its background. I'll cancel it since I like my original color. This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. Thanks for watching.